Till now we have seen what a Java program and a sample program, where how you write a Java program in order to print a normal string message, welcome to tutorials point. But let us now see in advance, if you have to store some certain information and then display it, how will you do? For an example, we take a class human which has certain data and behavior, right? The data may be of age, the name or a department, anything, right? So you need to store these values somewhere, some memory. So what variable does is that a variable will provide you or allocate a piece of memory where it allows you to store your value in that particular piece of memory. But that memory, what type of value will it store, or what size of that value it will allow you to store, you need to decide on that. And how do you decide, or how the computer determine what size or type of value it will accept and will allow you to store, is done by a data type. So here the data types are nothing but which allows or which tell you what kind of a data or what size of a data will you be able to store. For an example, if you have to store an integer value, you use int, int, right? This is a numerical. There are certain other data types which allows you to store integer values, and there are certain data types which also allows you to store textual values and so on. In the going forward video, we'll see what are the data types which will allow you to store different kinds of values. You have two types of data types in the previous slide, as you must have seen, that are primitive, which are also called as value type, non-primitive, which are called reference. What is the main difference between primitive and reference? Primitive data types are certain which allows you to store simple values, and these values or the size or the type of value is predefined in Java. You cannot modify the set of operation for these primitive data types. Whereas in reference, the class objects or the array variables that you create are nothing but reference data types. And these variables are created using the constructor of that particular class. In the going forward, we'll see how you create these reference objects. Okay. For now, we have to understand what are these data types and what are the difference between these data types. So primitive data type, which holds the value or which allows you to hold one of these kind of value, will be stored in stack, whereas in reference they will store the value in heap. Why is that kind of a difference? Because the primitive data value size is predefined, whereas in reference you cannot predefine the value. For an example, you may not know what data or what output you would want to print. So the string value is unknown. Therefore, you use in that case string data type, or when you do not know the size of the value, it may be string, it may be integer, it may be any format, you use arrays and then certain class objects. In primitive data type, you have certain numeric, textual and boolean. Where boolean stands, it provides you one bit of information that may be true or false, and then textual, a byte or a char, which allows you a one bit information, and then the numeric is nothing but your int, long, short, double, float, etc. So let us now understand the comparison of each of these primitive data types. In this chart, as you can see, the first and the second, byte and short, are the two complements integer. It means that they are used mainly to save the memory space in array, and these are nothing but byte is 4 times shorter than int, and short is 2 times shorter than int. Therefore, and whereas int is a by default integer value, it means if you have to store any numerical value, int is a default type. And you can see the comparison, what is the size, 8, 16, 32, and then 64 is nothing but long. Where you are trying to store a numerical value and integer, but you are unable to, that is the value is larger than what you can store in int, is nothing but done with help of long, which is of 64 bits. Next you come to float and double. Float and double are nothing but which allows you to store decimal value. By default that you use in Java to store decimal value is double, and float is nothing but used to save the space of an array of floating point. One point to remember in case of float and double is that both of them cannot be used for precise values, like you will not be able to store the currency values. The next two are char and boolean. char enables you to store a single character. A boolean will either return true or false. By default, value of boolean is false.